My name is Laura Foster. I'm 12 years old, and I have a story to tell. An amazing, bone-chilling story. When the day comes to an end and I leave school, there's honestly not a lot to do other than play Roblox. It's definitely become my favorite pastime, joining different worlds, meeting new friends. It's all such a thrill. But one of those friends I made was a little special. I talked to a lot of friends, but I would talk even more to this other player that I kept bumping into. Truth or Dare 248 was his username, and he seemed pretty nice. There was just something about the way he talked that I really liked. I guess it was his wicked sense of humor. He just always seemed to know just what to say, and time would just whisk away in the blink of an eye, until my parents would come and remind me that it's time for bed. But there was one night when they couldn't do that. An old friend of my dad's was getting married and had invited both of my parents to attend. But the wedding reception was pretty far, and they knew they wouldn't make it back until very late at night, or maybe even early morning of the next day. They wanted to hire a babysitter for me, but I insisted that I was old enough to spend the night alone. I promised them I'd be responsible and go to bed on time. I wasn't scared either. All the doors would be locked. What was there to be afraid of? Eventually, my parents gave up and agreed to give me a chance. I said goodbye and quickly went back to the computer. Finally, without them around, I could play even more Roblox than usual. It was the weekend, so no school either. I played for several hours until the sun started to set. I wondered where Truth or Dare was. He was always online. Always. But not today. At least, not yet. I pulled the curtain back from the window next to me and saw it was nighttime. Probably time for me to go to bed. But perhaps I could keep playing just a little longer. And just when I decided to do so, I saw Truth or Dare come online. I didn't see his character, but I received a message from him. A weird kind of message, in a way that he didn't usually speak in. "You still haven't answered the question," it suddenly read. "Will you tell me a horrible truth, or take a leap of faith with a dare?" I felt a cold shiver run down my spine. He was acting weird, very weird. It didn't help that I was home alone. In fact, it only made it worse. Every creak and squeak the house made gave me a startle, making me paranoid that someone, or something, was in the house with me. But I had to be imagining things. I was just way too freaked out, so I scrambled to my mouse and keyboard to unfriend Truth or Dare. I guess I did have fun talking to him, but if he was going to try to be strange and spooky, I'd rather not talk anymore. But it was exactly the moment I unfriended him that I heard a loud, frantic knock at my door. It jolted me out of my chair, and I stared at the door. I had no idea who it could be. It was too late at night to be one of the neighbors, but perhaps it was my parents. Maybe they forgot their keys. If they did, I needed to help them back in. I opened the door with a painful creak and poked my head out to see who it was. But it was not my parents. There was a shadowy figure lingering outside, hidden behind a thick black robe from head to toe. The black clothes made it look like he was blending into the darkness of the night, and I could barely make him out. But then I looked down to see the shape of his hand, holding something that looked like the branch of a tree or something similar to it. He pointed it at me. "Truth or Dare?" He snarled at me in a deep, disturbing voice. In an instant, I panicked, trying my very best to shut the door, but the shadowy man was faster than me. With a forceful shove, he pushed through and slammed the door open. I thought he must have been a thief, forcing his way in to steal everything that we had. But no, he did not care about our valuables at all. It seemed like all he was interested in was me. Pulling a small hood out of his shapeless black robe, he forced it onto my head to blind me. My sight was plunged into darkness, and I could only kick and scream as I felt him drag me out of the house. Where was he taking me? Was he going to hurt me? I desperately wanted answers, but I got none. I don't know how much time passed after that. It was mostly a blur. I fought him as best as I could the entire time, but he just kept dragging me, not stopping or even slowing down. He was like an evil force of nature. Eventually, my hands slipped free from his grip, and I used them to quickly pull my hood off. I opened my eyes to see old, broken-down plywood around me, as well as a few tools scattered on the floor like hammers and nails. It smelled like grease and paint. I was in an abandoned shed, I believed. The shadowy man was nowhere to be found. Where did he go? And more importantly, when was he coming back? I definitely wasn't going to wait around to find out. This was probably my only chance to escape. I rushed over to the shed door and rattled the worn-down handle, but it wouldn't open. Locked. I would have to take inspiration from my kidnapper. Carefully taking a few steps backwards, I lunged and threw my shoulder forward, slamming against the door. Thud. The door shook, but didn't open. I tried again. Thud. Still, the door remained shut, but its bronze hinge came a bit loose from the impact. If I just gave it one more try. Thud. I don't know how I did it, but I broke down the door, forcing it to swivel open and let me out. After that, I did what anyone else would have done. I ran as fast as my legs could carry me, surrounded in every direction by tall trees. But I kept running until I knew I was far, far away from that shed. When I finally ran out of breath, I swiftly pulled my phone out of my pocket and dialed 911. I told them everything that had happened to me, and it didn't take long until I was found by several policemen and women. They called my parents, and soon they were back, comforting me as best as they could. I tried to answer the police's questions the best that I could, but I really couldn't tell them anything detailed about the shadowy man. I didn't know anything about what he actually looked like. He was like an actual ghost of the night. When the police finally escorted us home, I climbed into my bed and my parents kissed me goodnight, promising me that this would never happen again, and that the police would definitely catch the man who tried to kidnap me. But for some reason, I just didn't believe them. And just when the lights in my room went out, and my parents stepped outside, I quietly snuck out of bed to sit at the computer one more time. It was really strange, but I just couldn't shake off this feeling that all of this had something to do with what happened on Roblox. And sure enough, my heart started to race again when I looked at my friend list and saw the impossible. Someone had come back, forced their way back into my friend list, and they were ready to talk once again. Truth or Dare was online.